Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. We needed to define what is a functional group. So I have a definition on the screen. This is not a textbook definition, but a functional group, and we often call functional groups FG for short. Functional groups are local regions of structure within a molecule. So a key thing to notice here is a functional group, a molecule can contain multiple functional groups. So let's look at an example of a molecule. This is drawn in line angle notation. And most chemists would look at this molecule and they'd say it has two notable functional groups. One is this one here, that's an alcohol, and we'll learn how to identify these later. And over here is this carbon-carbon double bond, and people would call this an alkene. And so you may have a, let's say you work in a laboratory and you have another chemist in the room, and there's a bottle of this chemical on the shelf, and you want to do a reaction on this molecule, and you might specifically want to do chemistry on this alcohol on the left. Well, you might say, hey, has anybody seen the bottle of this alcohol? So you might refer to the molecule as an alcohol. It's not the only functional group in the molecule, but that's what you're interested in. You're interested in that part of the molecule. Meanwhile, your lab mate may want to do chemistry on the alkene. So your lab mate might say, hey, has anybody seen the bottle of that alkene? It used to be on the shelf. So this is an important way to refer to molecules. And we kind of, when we refer to functional groups, we are communicating what is the part of the molecule that we're going to react on. Functional groups are also good for referring to other parts of the molecule. So this molecule has six carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if you said, oh, this molecule, that carbon does a certain reaction, someone might say, that carbon, there are six carbons of the molecule. Which particular carbon? You can say, oh, it's the carbon next to the alcohol. And then you know immediately, they must mean that particular carbon. So by learning our functional groups, we're actually learning ways to talk about chemical reactivity, but we're also learning how to communicate. And in this course, we will very often communicate by referring to functional groups. So we need to know our functional groups. Functional group names, right? I'm not a fan of memorization, but these are things we just have to memorize. And fortunately, we will use them over and over again, so the memorization will come pretty naturally. But this is a memorization type of task.